Hello friends, this particular video is to understand how to generate certificates in bulk, not just to generate certificates in bulk, but certificates which have multiple variables in it, and also how to send it to individual email IDs. And all of this happening within minutes. In our schools, we do organize events like inter-school competitions or intra-school competitions, wherein large number of participants are there, and we are supposed to be giving certificates to all of them, and this requires a lot of manpower, time and energy. So let's see, how can we save our energy? So let's assume we are organizing an inter-school literary fest in which approximately 50 schools are participating and there are 500 students, and you are supposed to be giving a different type of certificates to different students and send it to each one's individual IDs. So let's see, how can we do it? So let's learn how to create personalized certificates and send it to individual email IDs. For this, we'll require two things. One is the Excel sheet, and second is the certificate. So let's have a look at both of these. So this is the Excel sheet. And here we have the participant's name, school name, competition name, position which the student has got, and the email ID. Now, this is the one which has all the position holders, because for the position holders, the certificate will be different. And for those who have not won first, second, third prize and they have just participated, the certificate will be different. So you can have two different sheets for them. And here I have just made four entries. Your list will be long, definitely. So now let's have a look at this certificate. This is the certificate of Inter-School Literary Fest. I've made a very simple one, awarded to. Here the name of the student will be there, of whichever school the child belongs to. Then for participating in, what is the name of the competition, and securing first, second, third position, whatever. Now here we have to put it within these two tags. So the name, school's name, competition name, position, all of these are the variables which it will pick from the Excel sheet. So you have to put all the variables between these two tags. And remember, when you're putting the name over here, just see that the font, size, color, everything should be the one which you want on the certificate. So accordingly, you can just put these variables in the certificate. Now, once this is done, we will now upload the certificate as well as the Excel sheet on the Google Drive. So we'll upload both of these documents on Google Drive. So I've got this document. First, let's go to the certificate. Now you can see this is a .pptx file. So what you have to do is you have to save it as Google Slides. So this is saved as Google Slides now. Let's save our certificate in a folder. So we will go to Move, create a new folder, and name it as, say, Literary Fest. Now let's go to the Excel sheet. Now this Excel sheet also, it is a .xls file, and we have to convert this into Google Sheets. So this is our Google Sheet, and here we will go to Add-ons, Get Add-ons, and this Autocrat is what you have to install. So you will install. Okay. Now what we can also do is, there are times when you want that some people in the list should go get the certificate and some of them should not get it. If suppose that kind of a thing is there in your Excel sheet. So what you can also do is you can create one more column and create a condition. So you can insert a column anywhere. And you can name that column as condition. So, which means that the certificate will be created only when that condition is fulfilled. So, let's say the condition is that when if yes is written, then the certificate will be created. Okay. Now we will go to add-ons and open AutoCrat. We'll go to new job and let's name it as Literary Fest. And move to next. From the drive, we will take the certificate. Let's pick this certificate. Select. So this has been selected now. Let's move on to next. So now we can see that the tags are here. Name, school's name, competition name, and position. These were the tags in the certificate. Now we have to map these tags to the Excel sheet. So the name will be participant's name, school's name will be school name, competition name will be name of the competition, and position will be position. It has already taken. So now this is done. Let's move on to next. Now the file name, so if you just go here and file name can be your participant's name. Now how do you want, what type output do you want? You want it in the form of a PDF and multiple output, not just one single certificate. You want many certificates simultaneously. So multiple output and then move to next. This says choose a folder. If there is a particular folder in which you want all the certificates to go, you can choose that particular folder. Here we have already created a folder in our drive, the Literary Fest folder. So let all the certificates go in this folder. So we can click on next. But if you want that different schools, different folders are there and you want their certificates to go in their folder, so then you can accordingly create those folders in your Google Drive and choose those folders. We'll move to next. Add dynamic folder reference. This is not required. We don't want any other folder reference to be done here. So we'll move next. It says add condition. And yes, we had added the condition. So we'll put here. Condition is that if there is a yes, if the column condition equals to yes, then the certificate will be printed. So we'll move to next. Now share docs and send emails. Yes, we want that the personalized email should go. So, and the doc will be shared as PDF. We had already selected that. Now if you want them to reshare, you can click a yes. Send from generic, no reply address. But if you want a reply, you can say no. Now, to whom it has to be sent? So you can again go here and select email ID. So the email ID can be put over here. Type the subject. Subject could be certificate, Literary Fest. And then you can type your message. It could be dear. And then because you are making it personalized, so the name, participant's name can come over here. Or if you're writing it to the school principal and sending all the certificates together, you can write the principal's name out there. And then let's write the body of the mail. So it is done. Now we will move to next. Now you want it to run on triggers. Now this is run on form trigger. This is when you are collecting some information on the Google form and you want that as soon as that form is submitted, the certificate should reach the person. Only in that case, you can click this as a yes. But in our case, that's not the thing. So we'll click it as no. Run on time trigger. Time trigger is like on a specific time if you want all the certificates to be sent, but we don't want that. So we have clicked no on both of these features. Now we will save. All the things have been added, so we will save it. This is now ready, but let's preview. Let's preview how the certificate is going to look like. So preview for the first mergeable row. This has been created. So here we have the certificate awarded to name of the student, which school and which competition and what position. everything is over here. Of course, the design and the layout of it, font size, color, all of these things are in your hand and you can change it. So this is how the certificate will look like. We are satisfied. If we are satisfied with this, then we are going to run the job. Now it's showing only one row is merged. Why? Because in the condition, we had just put yes on one of the rows. So let's see. Let's go to, this is our Excel sheet. And here you can see that this particular certificate has been created. Now, if you want the other certificates also to be created, so you can just put a yes everywhere and then go to add-ons again and then autocrat. So already this is existing, the job is existing. So we will just run. Three rows are merged. So we can see here that the certificate is being, these two certificates, all the certificates have been created. Now let us see how our certificates are looking. So we will go to our Google Drive and check it out in the folder. The folder was Literary Fest. And here we have all these certificates. Let's just check out one of the certificate here. This is how the certificate is. And then you can check out the other certificates. All the certificates have been created. Now let us see, because we had asked for personalized emails, so let's check our email also. So this is the email. All the four emails are over here. Let's click open one. And this is a personalized mail which has gone to the student with the certificate. So isn't this a very easy task to do? And it does not take much time and it makes our task really simple. So I hope, friends, that the task of writing these certificates have become easy for you. Now when you organize events, you don't have to generate a certificate committee who's going to be creating all the certificates. Just one person on the computer will be able to do the job. So if you have liked this video, don't forget to share it with your fellow educators. And also don't forget to share, like, and subscribe this channel. Thank you so much.